Dear officers and members of the CEGP, as an alumnus of the College Editors Guild of the Philippines since the 1950s, I'm happy to express my support to this noble organization and champion of press freedom as it celebrates its 90th founding anniversary, as well as National Campus Press Freedom Day on July 25, 2021. I congratulate you for making your own recent contributions to the accumulated achievements of the CEGP as the oldest, broadest, and only existing alliance of tertiary student publications in the Asia-Pacific region. You have acted excellently to uphold, defend, and advance press freedom on and off campus. And I support the series of activities and journalism skills training program that you will conduct today. I'm sure that these will enhance your ability to report the facts, the issues, and the views that must be communicated to the student constituency as well as to the general public. It is appropriate and highly significant that you convene all student journalists nationwide in an online discussion. This program gives you, even under the conditions of the COVID-19 pandemic, the opportunity to celebrate your anniversary as well as to exercise your freedom to discuss the urgent issues of today in our country. It is your duty to continue the mission of the CEGP in informing and educating student journalists regarding the plight of the country and encouraging the student masses and the rest of the people to express their views on events and issues and put forward their demands and propose solutions to the problems that characterize a semi-colonial and semi-feudal society and afflict most grievously the toiling masses of workers and peasants and even the intelligentsia. The crisis of the domestic ruling system and that of the world capitalist system have been rapidly worsening and compelling the people to make just demands for the respect of their basic national and democratic rights and interests. And yet the Duterte regime is obsessed with committing crimes of treason, tyranny, mass murder, plunder, and mass deception. Duterte is a traitor, trying hard to serve as puppet to conflicting imperialist powers. He allows the U.S. to have all-round domination over the Philippines in exchange for the violent means to suppress the People's Democratic Revolution and even the legal democratic mass movement. At the same time, he sells out to China Philippine sovereign and maritime rights in the West Philippine Sea in exchange for the most burdensome loans, exploitative investments, and bribes from Chinese corporations involved in the smuggling out of mineral ores and Chinese criminal syndicates involved in the smuggling in of illegal drugs. Duterte is definitely a tyrant, since decking out himself as belonging to the left and being socialist and pretending to be for peace negotiations for a short while in 2016, Duterte has brazenly engaged in all-out war against the revolutionary movement and unleash state terrorism against the entire Filipino people on the pretext of anti-communism and anti-terrorism. He is running amok and trying to kill the revolutionary movement and suppress even the legal democratic mass movement in the urban areas. His objective is to monopolize political power. So far, Duterte has become the biggest criminal in the Philippines by ordering his armed minions to commit the mass murder of more than 30,000 alleged drug users and peddlers. Has become the supreme drug lord as a result of the bogus war on drugs. Since 2017, he has been trying to extend his killing spree to the revolutionary movement as well as to the legal democratic movement. He and his favorite generals have been getting the lion's share from the rapidly enlarged appropriation for the military and police. Moreover, they have benefited from the graft and corruption in erstwhile civilian departments and agencies that have been militarized. Actually, Duterte boasts of feeding the generals with money. In so short a time, Duterte, his family, and cronies have enriched themselves at a rate faster than the Marcos family and cronies did in the past. They get big cuts from government purchases, loan contracts, and budgetary appropriations for pork barrel and military overspending. The military campaign of suppression in the hinterlands have escalated not only to oppress the indigenous people and poor settlers, but also to give away the land and natural resources to foreign and domestic mining, logging, and plantation companies. As a fascist-minded bureaucrat capitalist, Duterte's drive for absolute power is clearly a drive for absolute corruption. He has absolutely no social conscience. He has increased the national debt by 2 trillion pesos within a year and has pushed up the appropriations for mass testing, ayuda, vaccines, and medical treatment. But he and his bureaucratic and military cronies have pocketed most of the money. Even the frontlining health workers have not been given adequate personal protection equipment and the necessary allowances. Despite all the crimes that he has committed, Duterte has used the fascist formula for conjuring a high popularity rating, so-called, by using state terrorism and mass deception, hyping him as the almighty ruler and vilifying the entire range of opposition with the use of cywar by all bureaucratic and military agencies, mercenary opinion poll survey firms, troll armies, and corrupt sections of the corporate media. Duterte and his followers calculate that they have succeeded at intimidating the people with the bloody crimes of armed suppression and misleading them with disinformation campaigns. They seem to be unaware that the broad masses of the people are already exceedingly outraged by the crimes of Duterte, the atrocities committed by the military, police, and paramilitary, the extreme aggravation of mass unemployment, mass poverty, mass hunger, breakdown of production, and the skyrocketing prices of basic commodities. They are not ashamed of the extreme greed manifested by having daughter and father as candidates for president and vice president. They are confident of rigging the 2022 elections in order to counter the prospect of a warrant of arrest from the International Criminal Court, and they continue to keep the option of declaring a pseudo-revolutionary government at any time in order to impose a fascist dictatorship on the people and prevent the people from rising up against electoral fraud. All the crimes of Duterte have been enabled and facilitated by the crimes of tyranny, state terrorism, mass intimidation, and mass deception. It is therefore of utmost importance for the CEGP and all campus journalists to resolutely and militantly perform their role and duty of truth-telling and smash all the lies that Duterte and his followers have generated in order to oppress and exploit the people at an accelerated rate on an unprecedented scale. The CEGP must be guided by the principles and program of full national independence and genuine democracy to uphold, defend, and promote. You have a fine tradition to adhere to in this regard. Remember and be inspired by the examples of revolutionary journalists in both the old and new democratic revolutions. And you have the will and the way to make further achievements in contributing to the realization of the people's aspirations for a new democratic revolution against imperialism and the local exploiting classes. Long live the College Editors Guild! Uphold, defend, and advance press freedom! Carry forward the new democratic revolution! Long live the Filipino people!